Alrighty, you want to call it in the air?
I will call it in the air. Heads.
It's tails. I was gonna catch it and flip it, but it's tails.
It's tails. That's fine.
Hey everybody, Chris from Six Wins. This is Matt. And this is the moment, well, we've been waiting for.
Yeah.
You all haven't really been waiting for, but we've been trying to connect with as many wrestling fans as possible. But this is it. This is where we put together the bracket for best male WWE superstar of all time. Matt's going to get into some of the rules and logistics, but I just want to throw out this quick disclaimer. So Six Wins, as of right now, is just Matt and I. So we do all the shooting, we do all the social media, we do all of the videos when we go out, we do all of the editing. So we're going to try to put as many graphics up on the screen as we're talking, but as we're talking right now, we don't know which graphics and we don't know which direction this is going to go. But what we do have is a list that we've compiled of about 100, little more than 100 total male WWE superstars that we've gotten through our own, you know, we've picked our own, and then we've gotten a ton of submissions. Thank you everyone for your submissions. We got a lot of names on here that we would have missed otherwise, some like really big names. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna kind of do a bounce back and forth. I'm gonna compile a list. Matt's gonna keep time, and I think that's it for me. Matt, did you want to throw in a little bit about the rules and a little bit about what's happening here today?
Yeah, like Chris said, I'll talk a little bit about the rules, and also, as he said, we want to get in as much as edits as we can, so you can kind of see what we're looking at or the bracket as it goes on. But of course, at the very least, as we finish the bracket, we'll probably be able to throw up the final thing so you can look and see everything. So you don't have to go back and be like, who's up against who again? And then, you know, we'll have that shared around as we start the, you know, daily polls to see who goes on to be best male WWE superstar of all time. So with that said, choosing a best anything, like, best is always so subjective. And there's no objective criteria for what makes, like, the perfect wrestler. A lot of people probably, when they hear best wrestler, you're either going to think like most popular, which doesn't always equate to a best wrestler, or like best technically sound, which doesn't always mean that, like, if we were just picking like the strongest guys who can do the most technically sound guys, we'd have people like Great Khali in here because he was really big and really strong, and Braun Strowman would be a one seed and things like that. Mm-hmm. So for wrestler, we are taking into account everything, which is your wrestling skill in ring, strength, ability to carry a promotion and be like the main guy for years or months, your mic skills, your ability to connect with fans, like all of these things are going to be how we try to at least accurately seed as well as we can the wrestlers in this bracket. Couple other rules, like Chris said, we're just gonna do male wrestlers only. It would get really tricky to start including like women wrestlers as well, so we may be able to do a separate bracket for that down the line. A couple other rules here, just in like who is a valid candidate for the bracket. WWF and or WWE superstars only. They don't have to be in the promotion anymore, obviously. We're going to be talking about some legends that are retired and things like that. But wrestlers that have only ever appeared in like NJPW overseas or in the indies or only been in AEW, they are not going to be eligible. We are not opening it up to like just that amount of additional wrestlers and like, you know, decades and periods where we'd have to like really do some deep research for like who could be added and learn just way too much than we ever possibly could.
Stop. Walks the top rope. My God!
Another rule, no tag teams. We are only picking solo wrestlers. If a guy has been on a tag team, but has had like a very notable solo run, he may be in this. But so you are going to see some really great tag teams, like some of the most memorable wrestling superstars, just as famous as some solo guys that aren't going to be in here because we just wanted to have one wrestler versus one wrestler instead of like one wrestler versus a tag team. So you might not see like a Scott Steiner. He did have a good solo run. You and probably won't see the Usos, who right now are very popular, incredible tag team, like some of the best matches frequently on pay-per-views. But odds are, as a solo superstar, they probably haven't done enough to make it into this bracket. A little bit about the bracket and how we're doing it, though. As Chris said, he mentioned something about a timer. We have this list, and the plan is for us to kind of do like a bit of a draft. We're going to flip a coin to see who goes first, and then we are each going to go down the line, and whoever wins that first coin toss is going to pick their first number one seed. And they'll have 30 seconds for each pick as we go down the line. So if Chris wins the coin toss, we'll put him on the clock. He'll have 30 seconds to pick somebody that he thinks should be a one seed. And then after that, I have 30 seconds to pick somebody that's a one seed. And we'll go down the line ones, twos, threes, until we get to 16s. And that is how we will compile our bracket.
You're here. I'm here. Let's do this!
We can start the timer. We each get 30 seconds to hammer home our pick, but I don't think I'll need the full 30. Because my first pick, who I think is the greatest WWE superstar of all time, it's no surprise I'm wearing a shirt, Stone Cold Steve Austin. All right. I'm going to throw up in the first number one seed.
Stone Cold is number one. Yeah, he probably for sure would have been a one seed no matter who was picking. I'm on the clock now for 30 seconds. So, you know, I'm going to go with... It's this rivalry, I think because of when we grew up, this rivalry is one of just the most famous and most important for, like, that era. And I know it's putting two guys from the same kind of timeline, but I'm going to pick The Rock.
All right.
As the number one seed here.
The Rock region. Love it. Okay, so it's on me to go with my second number one seed. Looking down the list, I got about 20 seconds here. A lot of names that have an argument here, but I'm going longevity. I'm going just the locker room leader, the backbone, a name that's synonymous with pro wrestling. Mark Calloway himself, The Undertaker.
Ah, Undertaker is a one. All right, I'm going to put myself on the clock here. So this is tough, because those three guys all definitely overlapped and were in their primes. And I feel a little bad that, like, I don't know, are we getting, like, a current guy, like, a guy maybe just before that? So one kind of era is might get left out of, like, a one seed here, like, our current or maybe the one before it. So I'm going to go Hogan and pick the generation right before that one. Obviously, Hogan had most of his career, a lot of his career in WCW, but he obviously came over to WWF and started in WWF, of course, too. Mm-hmm. So right. He had his middle part, which is maybe the most famous to me, but his WWF, WWE stuff is incredibly important to the history of wrestling.
Right, so in a way, between us, we have just selected our Mount Rushmore.
I guess, yeah.
Austin, Rock, Taker, Hogan. So... Sound Matt, you're on the clock, 30 seconds. Who is the first number two seed?
I am on the clock. We're going to two seeds. So there's a couple options here. And I will also preface this because you said we just picked our Mount Rushmore. I'm personally like a mid-card guy. Some of my favorite superstars are like upper mid-card. I love Seth Rollins. I loved like Mick Foley, Mankind growing up. He was like my favorite. I loved some of these like not top guys. So, like, these are hard for me to pick. So, for a two seed, my first two seed, though, I am going to go with another big name, John Cena.
Woo!
How could he not be up there? And the alarm is going off because I got right down to the end of that one and didn't restart it, but snuck it in just in time.
Okay, I am back on the clock for my number two seed. So, this is the Rock region. And gosh, there's so many, just like number two, number three, that 2, 3, 4 is so many like quality names, but I think who I'm going to go with here, the Nature Boy, woo!
That surprises me. I did not see Ric Flair. I didn't see the Ric Flair being picked here, the Ric Flair.
Woo!
30 seconds on the clock. Ah, see, now this is tough. Part of me wants... Oh, I've got a few picks here. Man, this is so hard. I think I'm going to go... I think what we don't have is, like, a super current guy yet in sort of our first eight. Like, nobody that's currently active. So there's two options I'm thinking. Lesnar, who's not full-time, and or Roman Reigns. I'm going to give it to Lesnar and put Lesnar as my two. And I'm going to give it to Lesnar because of Lesnar's longevity as well. And Lesnar also kind of had some crossover with some of these legends, The Rock and Cena. And, like, Roman Reigns has done it, you know, ever since his Shield days, but it's still, like, those guys. He hasn't done it with another generation, really.
Yeah.
So I think Lesnar... Yeah, I'm going Lesnar, too.
Dude, people don't realize Lesnar's been back for, what, 10 years?
Yeah. He's a freak.
Right.
He comes out, his matches frighten me.
Yeah.
I'm worried he's going to forget and, like, really snap a guy's arm. So there's always that extra bit of tension with a Lesnar match.
Yeah. I don't want to detour too much, but who do we see Lesnar going against at Mania?
Do you think he'll have a match at Mania?
I think so.
Do you think they'll run back Lashley?
I hope not. If I have to criticize Lesnar, it's just his matches. Thinking Reigns, like, there's only so many people you can pair him with, but, like,
yeah,
Lesnar could go. I wouldn't mind a Lesnar Gunther.
Ooh,
I think would be sweet.
Yes, that would actually be really good.
Yeah, I mean,
I'd be down for that.
I mean, he's always been in, like, that top world title picture, but, like, what a way to get Gunther over, beating Lesnar clean, or putting IC title on Lesnar. Let him workhorse for a little bit.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. That'd be cool.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm on the clock with my...
One more two seed, I think,
number two.
Right?
Yeah, sure do. Alrighty. So I don't know that I can put this particular person any lower. I don't know who I'm going to pick, but maybe you can guess if you're watching. A lot of people say his second run was just as good, if not better, than his first run. The Heartbreak Kid.
Okay,
Shawn
yeah.
Michaels. I'm throwing HBK in that Hogan region because of their classic matchup where he sold and ran around the building. We're back up at the Stone Cold region.
Mm-hmm.
Northwest corner of the bracket. I think we need some new blood in here as well. And I don't think we'll ever get it, but I would love an Austin Reigns feud, just in theory. So I'm going to throw Roman Reigns in that number three here.
Right on. Yeah. And, Roman Reigns there. All right. So we did get Roman Reigns on there. He slipped below Brock Lesnar. Maybe people are like, Matt, how could you? Lesnar's a part-timer. Lesnar was a full-timer a long time ago. Come on.
Right.
Give me a break.
Right.
All
right.
So I'm on the clock. My first number three choice. Oh, and it's getting tough. There are a couple, like, you know, legends on here to pick from. There are a couple sort of, you know, Attitude Era guys. I might go personal bias here, because we're getting to that part where, like, these guys are hard to separate. And I am going to go personal bias. I am going to go Chris Jericho.
Sweet.
I think he's the full package as a wrestler. His ability to get over weird gimmicks.
You just made the list!
So we're back up at the Undertaker region.
Yeah.
And Undertaker... It's got me thinking Attitude Era. And we're mid-30s, guys. So, like, you know, for a little, you know, geared towards Attitude Era, a lot of people say that was a peak. Well, that was definitely my peak. And so I am going with The Game. Triple H. With the resurgence he's had, you know, going from the guy who's known for burying everybody to the guy who's, like, literally turned WWE around in terms of creative and just storylines and storytelling. So, yeah, Triple H, number three seed. All right, you're up for number three seed in the Hogan bracket.
Yeah, I think we've gotten a little too maybe overlooked some of the older guys for a couple of these seeds. Most of the twos and threes were all fairly recent guys, none of the, like, Hogan era or earlier. So I'm going to jump back. This is going to be a tough one, though. But, I mean, we've got, like, two of Hogan's biggest rivals to choose from, or maybe three of his biggest rivals. I'm going to go with Macho Man for my number three seed.
Can we get your Macho Man impression?
Ooh, yeah, brother. It's the Macho Man, Randy Savage.
The Hams, too.
The Hams, brother. Yeah. I love those Slim Jim commercials.
Yeah. Can I tell you my biggest beef with Macho Man?
Slim Jim? Is that the punchline? Because of these Slim Jim's beef?
That's really funny.
That's a terrible joke.
And then
you're
going to complete my
thought. No, it's not. No, please do. What's your biggest beef with Macho Man?
Slim Jims didn't actually snap. False advertising.
Yeah.
They bent and they were kind of mushy.
It wouldn't make that noise. You can go, snap into a Slim Jim. Ooh, yeah. Snap into a line. Cut my promos, brother.
Wait, no, that's Hogan. Dude, Hogan.
No, that's, yeah. All right, so we're on four seeds and it's me. Oh, shoot.
Nope.
All right, I'm on the clock. Four seeds. I want to look at who's in this region and maybe try and start finagling some interesting matchups. I'm not going to try and finagle. This one, I think I'm going to go Macho Man and Ultimate Warrior back-to-back. I'm going to put Ultimate Warrior here as a four because it's really hard to choose who got that three. And I think got to respect the Hogan era.
Come on in! We're nightmares on the best part of my day! I live for anger and frustration! Combat is where I will be! I look above to the gods!
I'm gonna keep with the theme of old school guys.
Oh, okay.
Because one could be said, this is a little before my time, one could be said that there is no pro wrestling without this gentleman right here. I'm gonna throw Bruno Sammartino in there so we get some, put some respect on his name.
I think that's fair, yeah.
Yeah.
I think it wouldn't be a list, a encapsulating list, without kind of really having him on there.
Right,
so, yeah.
Agreed.
All right, so another four seed. Man, I've got a few options I'm running through. And again, I might let personal bias get in here. I'm going to go a little bit of curveball here.
Okay.
But I think this wrestler, what he, his importance to, like, younger kids growing up and, like, the younger audience as he's wrestling and just his longevity and everything is can't be said enough. I'm going to throw Rey Mysterio.
Dang, okay.
Very high. He has been doing it for a long time, and he's consistently one of the most popular wrestlers, and he's incredible in ring. Like,
right.
The luchador style was one of my favorites growing up. I love WCW Cruiserweight division.
Yeah.
Actually, it's like my favorite. And so, like, you know, we got to have a luchador represent pretty high because that is an influential style of wrestling that a lot of the 80s wrestling didn't do. But now, guys, you know, flippy guys.
Flippy shit.
Flippy guys. And without luchadors, I don't know if you see that. You still probably see just Hogan's body slamming people. So Rey Mysterio kind of brought that into mainstream. So I think, you know, maybe he's overlooked for that.
Mm-hmm. For sure. I like it.
Yeah.
Okay. Gosh, there's so many, and it's such a good list. But I got the next two. I got the final number four in the Hogan region. And then I pop back up for the fifth pick. I'm going to go a little personal bias, too. And some may say it's too soon to have this gentleman up there. But I think he has surpassed HBK. I said it. I'm going the architect. I'm going Seth Rollins.
You know he's
Seth
my favorite.
Freaking Rollins, number four seed. Let's push this man to the moon.
Oh, I
love
it. Not
biased, but
I'm very biased, and I think part of me wanted to pick him because I love him. He's like my favorite wrestler currently and one of my favorites of all time. But if I would have put him anywhere, I would have felt like I'm cheating the game. I'm cheating the system. I'm just like, I'm putting Seth Rollins on here because I like him. But yeah, he's incredible. All right, you are back on the clock for a five.
Okay. Man, there's been a lot of people to do it at a high level in WWE and WCW. Mm-hmm. And I know we're leaving WCW out, but there's like still remnants. And not very many people made the switch from the invasion angle to be catapulted into like main event scene in WWF, WWE. I'm going the five-time. I'm going five-time Booker T at number five seed.
Oh, Booker. King Booker. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, I like seeing that. That surprised me. Oh my god, that's incredible. All right, well, I gotta get my five seed in here. We're moving along, but we didn't have a script, but we tiered our wrestlers kind of as a way to help us, so like we don't have to look through an alphabetical list and like actually miss like an obvious number two seed because we just missed their name. Kind of have them tiered like main eventers, mid-carders, jobbers, which isn't fair. None of them were jobbers.
No.
I'm just gonna throw this out here though. I'm gonna go Bret Hart as my five. I think he's considered one of the most technically proficient in-ring performers. He was a massive WWF superstar.
Whoa! Frustrated isn't a goddamn word for it! This is bullshit!
I don't think he'll win the bracket, but who knows? Maybe he'll. He was right all along.
Yeah. Andre the Giant.
There we go. That was the fastest pick so far of the bracket. Chris took about 2.5 seconds for that one.
Andre in the Taker region. All right, you got back-to-backs.
Got back-to-backs. I need a 5 and a 6. The 5. Somebody that could end up facing Hogan in a Sweet 16 matchup. What would be something interesting? Oh, man, I'm trying to go down the list. This is not a matchup that makes a lot of sense, but I don't think I can have this guy be much lower, and I'm going to go Randy Orton.
I was going to snag him if you did.
Yeah, Randy Orton maybe dropped a little lower than I think we thought he might, and I think the one thing that might be holding Randy Orton back from ever becoming like Mount Rushmoreable status is just probably his mic work. Mm-hmm. Sometimes when he gets good enough feuds and he gets to just play like a crazy pursuer and psychopath, he does great. And also like retiring Hall of Famers, that gimmick where he was just punting everybody in the head. That was an old guy. That was a great gimmick.
A legend killer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So yeah, Orton. Yeah, I mean Orton's got a very storied career. So I'm comfortable with him where I got him. And then 6. So the first 6 seed. This is the Stone Cold region. So I'm not gonna pick who I think I was because I might try and hold off and see if I can sneak this guy into another one. Mm-hmm. You know what? This makes sense. I don't think he'll make it to face up against Stone Cold, but they both famously had like a little promo where Stone Cold came down and sprayed the ring with beer, and Kurt Angle came down to the ring and filled it with milk. I'm going Kurt Angle as my 6th seed. I mean, if you're talking in-ring performers and skilled wrestlers, this guy won a gold medal with a freaking broken neck. I'm pretty sure I heard that somewhere.
I won a gold medal with a broken freaking neck!
If you were to put him at a 1 or 2 seed, I don't know that anyone... You could make the argument.
Yeah, I could see him as a 2.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it actually is funny, like, him below Randy Orton. Even I just picked those back-to-back, but, like, really? If I think back, I would have to take Angle higher than Orton. But maybe if it nagled for a matchup by accident, I don't know.
Right.
All right, so Chris is on the clock with our next number 6 pick.
Okay. Man, oh, man, there's... I think I got it.
He thinks he's got...
I think I got it. I'm thinking, they don't want no, but a skate, but they don't really want no.
I know
it. Just a southern boy. I'm going CM Punk. No, I'm just kidding.
The phenomenal one.
We're going AJ, 6th seed in the Rock region. The phenomenal one. All right, 6th seed in the Undertaker region.
Matt's Do I finagle? Because this finagling doesn't really help. Let me look and see if there's somebody else I'd put here. 6th seed. I mean, we just went AJ Styles, who most of his career not in WWE, but his last like 6 or 7 years here, he's been, for his age, every bit as good as he ever was. Like, he proved himself that he could hang with WWE wrestlers.
Right.
I'm going to go with the guy that had a great, like, one of the most amazing WrestleMania runs. I'm going to go Daniel Bryan.
All right.
Here. A guy who had his biggest part of his career in WWE and now is not in WWE, so sort of the flip of AJ Styles. But Daniel Bryan's WrestleMania run is one of the most timeless.
Timeless. It was a timeless run.
It was a timeless time.
Gun to head. Of course, D. Bryant will be back for his Hall of Fame induction.
Yeah.
But will he ever wrestle in WWE again?
Oh, I don't think so.
No?
No! 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 No!
Tall order here. So I got the sixth seed in the Hogan region, and then I'm going to move on and get that seven for the Austin region. Okay. Maybe it's just because what we're talking about with AJ, Daniel Bryan. I'm going Punk.
You're going CM Punk. Going yeah, CM those, Punk. Yeah, those, for some reason, those three guys seem similar.
Yeah.
In their lower, smaller stature, but amazing in-ring ability, and also really good mic workers.
Really good mic workers.
I would love to just talk about those three and like rank them, like best mic worker out of the three, best in-ring out of the three. I think they'd all each get like a number one.
Yeah. I think if anything, AJ might be like on a slightly lower tier on mic skills.
I think so. I think CM Punk would be top mic.
Right.
In-ring ability, probably going, CM Punk might be a little bit below. I'd probably pick Styles or Bryan.
Right.
And then, I don't know, like, what would be a third category? Strength? Physical
veganism.
Strength.
Daniel Bryan.
Punk's straight edge. I don't know if that means he doesn't eat meat, though.
Okay. Yeah, who knows? Call in.
Let us know.
But we were talking about this, not to get too off subject, because we're going in a half hour. And if you're still with us, thank you so much. That means you're a big wrestling fan like we are, and we're really excited to roll out this bracket.
Or a big Chris and Matt fan like we also are.
Maybe they don't know a thing about wrestling. They're just like, these guys, we could watch for... But we
45 minutes.
Yeah, tops. But we were talking Daniel Bryan's run as the Planet's champion.
Yeah.
Super underrated. This was like after he came back from injury, after his like face run got kind of like, all right, his welcome back tour is done. Now, who would have thought he would have gone right into like this killer heel? And he was actually kind of the reason that Kofi Mania worked so well, because it was like the anti of WrestleMania 30 when he had his big, you know, underdog movement. Okay, so we're going 7 seed. Back up into the Stone Cold region, and oh man, I'm not gonna do it. I'm not gonna do it yet because I think we'll get there. 10 seconds. I'm gonna save that later. I'm going with Foley.
Foley, nice. Yeah. I was getting ready to pull the trigger on a Foley at some point, and I think it's a good spot.
Foley's one of your favorites, right?
He was definitely one of my favorites growing up. I loved the hardcore stuff. Before basketball games, when I was like in sixth grade or seventh grade, like me and one of my best friends who we loved wrestling and watch them. Like, we'd be like the locker rooms at away games, and we'd just start having like locker room matches, like hitting each other in the head with like the locker doors. Mm-hmm. And our coach would come and be like, "What are you guys doing? Save some energy for the game." We're like, "Nah, who cares? We just want to be wrestlers."
Oh,
like,
dude.
Beat each other with like curtains and shower curtain rods and things like that.
Dude.
Just destroyed like away junior high school locker rooms for no reason.
Right. We could be here all day, but when we get into the bracket, we could tell more of those stories. But
yeah.
How much trouble Mick Foley got me into growing up, doing like hardcore stuff. Like, I had this like girlfriend in sixth grade who like twisted her ankle and like was walking around on crutches. Me and a buddy decided it'd be an awesome idea to like take one of the crutches and like lay him down and like stop on it, snap the crutch. Super badass.
You broke the crutch.
So yeah, so many stories like that.
Oh my god, oh no.
All right, 7 seed.
All right, a 7 seed for me.
Rock region.
Rock region. Rock region. I am, you know, we might, if both of these guys win, we might get a really interesting matchup between the dirtiest player in the game and another dirty player. It sounds like I'm about to pick the Godfather or something. No, I'm going to pick Eddie Guerrero here for a 7 seed. I'm going to go Eddie Guerrero. I think a Guerrero Flair matchup in the second round, which might happen.
It would be so dirty.
It'd be the... All right, 2 more 7 seeds to go, and then we'll be wrapping up the top 32 guys and hitting that bottom 32, a bunch of jobbers if you ask me, but we still got to pick them.
Yeah, but
there's some amazing guys.
I know. It's getting so hard. Let's just run it. I got a quick thing to say. So, fully aware that like a lot of the newer guys wouldn't be around if it weren't for some of the trailblazers. So I think some of the trailblazers, that might be an argument. Like, we wouldn't have a so-and-so if it wasn't for so-and-so. But I'm talking about a guy who hasn't aged in 25 years because I want to see him versus Brock Lesnar. I'm going Bobby Lashley.
Oh, Bobby Lashley. Nice one.
Seven seed in the Undertaker region.
Ooh, all right.
Alrighty, Hogan region, number 7. Who you got?
Hogan region, number 7. I'm thinking, I'm between two right now. And it's either one of those guys that was a trailblazer, or one of those guys that also hasn't aged, and also was told was never going to wrestle again, but then came back and wrestled. I got back-to-back picks. I'm going to go Edge for my number 7.
Ooh, okay. Yeah. He hasn't missed a step, dude. He's so good.
Yeah. And then for my number 8, since I've got to bounce back, I think this guy fits right. A great 8. He was never a top guy, but he's an iconic wrestler that are some people's like favorites, very memorable moments and highlights in his career. I'm going to go Roddy Piper and get him in there out of the 8 seed.
Yeah. Piper deserves a high spot.
Yeah.
And yeah, that's a perfect. I like Piper in the Stone Cold region.
Yeah.
Because people always kind of compared the two.
Yeah.
Because it's just good mic work. And then they had like a little face off at one of the WrestleManias. It was after Austin retired,
yeah,
maybe like a 22 or 23. And
yeah, I can't remember that. Yeah.
Yeah. Piper was like talking his, you know, what in the ring, and then the glass shattered. And nothing like it when the glass shattered.
Yes.
So. Alrighty, moving on down Rock region. I got an 8th seed pick. I saw you do.
There's some juicy.
I know.
Choices here.
Yeah. You know what? I am gonna go with one of the Trailblazers.
Okay.
I'm gonna go Arn.
Okay.
I'm going Anderson. Yep.
Right on.
Yep. I think in a lot of people's, if a lot of other people are doing this, especially like older heads, Arn's probably going to be in the top 5 seats. Like,
yeah.
Legendary, timeless. Okay, so moving on up to the Undertaker side, 8th seed. Who could potentially face... I'm assuming Undertaker's going to move up, but you never know.
That
could be Repo Man.
I think... See, this is hard because we set up... there are two dream matches here. One that happened a bunch and I think has great closure. And one that never happened, and I think everybody wanted to see. And we could still finagle it, but it almost seems unfair to both of these guys. They probably could both be ranked higher. Mm-hmm. I'm going to go, because of WWF and WWE history, I am going to take Kane as my 8. If you're thinking you know the other guy I'm talking about, then you'll know why I think I'm picking Kane as a higher seed, because we're focusing on what they did in WWE, WWF.
Mm-hmm. That's good. Very fair.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm on the clock. We're moving down to the Hogan region. We're getting down to the nitty-gritty here.
So many juicy ones.
I know.
Just looking at these names.
Huh. I'm going Dusty.
Dusty!
Yeah!
Dusty
Rhodes.
All right.
Surprisingly, or probably not surprisingly, higher than Cody. We haven't gotten Cody down yet. I don't even know if Cody will make, you know, because if we're going strictly WWE.
Yeah.